Hollywood Studios this morning. So I've got a Star Wars outfit on, so I see.
Got my new t-shirt on.
Yeah. So. It's pretty. excuse me. So we're going to Galaxy's Edge to get some photos. Hopefully do some rides whilst we're there, because we haven't done hardly any rides in Hollywood Studios. It was too busy the other day. We went on the weekend. Is there anything specific we want to do?
Rise.
Rise of Resistance.
Have to do Rise. The fact that we haven't done it yet, we've got like 3 days, 4 days left.
It's
ridiculous.
Yeah, so we need to do that. So hopefully the queue's not like extortionately long, but we'll see. Anything else you want to do whilst we're there? What other rides are there? I've forgotten.
Slinky, Toy Story Mania.
Oh yeah, we need to do Toy Story Mania. I'm not so worried about Slinky Dog. If we miss that, that's fine. But Toy Story Mania, yes. And Mickey and Minnie's Runaway Railway. Yeah. Runaway Railway.
Yeah.
That one. Want to do those ones.
Yeah.
They're the three, ideally, we want to get done. And then later on today, we're going to Epcot in the evening, yeah?
Yes. So cool. Just see the evening show and stuff.
LUMIONOUS. We want to watch that properly, because we saw it the other day, but we only saw the fireworks. They didn't play the music where we were sitting, so... Yeah, so Hollywood Studios now, Epcot this evening. So we'll see you when we get to Hollywood Studios. We are here in Hollywood Studios. That bus was busy.
Yep. That's the first time we really kind of got to early morning magic, isn't it? So
yeah. And it is 8:15. Oh dear. So tired. And there was a family on the bus, and the mum was trying to fix, there was three kids, two parents, the mum was trying to fix the girl's ears, so she took the ears off because we were standing on the bus, she lost balance, and the little boy was talking to someone, and she hit the boy in the face with the ears by accident, and she was like, oh, I was trying to fix her ears, and the boy was like, you were trying to give me a black eye. It was so funny, I literally died on the bus, I was laughing so much. So funny. Anyway, through Hollywood Studios now. Skyliner! We're gonna go straight to Galaxy's Edge, which I assume would be everybody else's idea as well. We're gonna go straight for Rise of Resistance, yes?
Yeah, I think so. Get it done.
Yeah, it's probably gonna be a bit cute, but... Whatever.
Get it done, come out, do some photos.
Yeah.
And then get some food.
Yeah.
Jump over it.
And then maybe go for Toy Story Land for Toy Story Mania or something. We'll see how it goes. Hopefully it's not too bad.
This is
the way. Just got through.
You get rid of the finger thing when they want it.
Yeah, I know, I didn't realise. So I was like, I put my wristband on the thing and it went green, and I was just about to do my fingerprint and I was like, oh wait, it's green. She was like, go, go, go. I was like, oh, sorry. Because it's obviously busy. They're trying to get people in. So yeah, apparently they can just take away the fingerprint thing, but... you can see how busy it is, all the people. Now, are people heading towards Galaxy's Edge or Toy Story Land? What do we reckon?
Yeah, either way, that's probably...
Yeah.
A lot of people tend to go to Slinky.
Yeah, the people with families will probably go Slinky, I would have thought. We're going round to the left. Past Disney & Co. is there. Ba-da-ba-ba. Hope we actually get to do some rides today, because we haven't done hardly any rides in Hollywood Studios this trip. I think we've actually only done Swirling Saucers. Let's try and do some rides. Coming up to Galaxy's Edge now. So we're going in the, I don't know if this is the main entrance, I feel like this is the main entrance, which is past Muppet's Vision, which is over there. So quite a lot of people going there. I bet they're all going for rides. So we'll let you know how long the queue is when we get there. Hopefully it's not too bad. We're in the queue for Rise of Resistance. We joined the queue at just about 8:30. There was rumours going around the queue that it was closed or it was down, and there was loads of things, but we stayed in the queue anyway because we were like, well,
we haven't heard anything, and now we're walking through the queue. So if you're here really early and you hear rumours, ignore them.
It's shot on the app, but it says 30 minutes.
Yeah, it says 30 minutes on the app, so I don't know where that came from. But someone behind us said they went and asked a cast member, and the cast member said, oh, we don't know when we're going to open it, but obviously that they
someone
opened it.
Someone else went past, said yeah. It's not going to open until this afternoon.
Yeah, like, so... Exactly.
How would they know that it would be open this afternoon? Right?
Yeah, exactly. So it makes no sense. So we don't know if people are just making it up or if they just misheard or what. But yeah, if you hear rumours that you're at the beginning, in front of the queue, just unless a cast member tells you that they're true, ignore them. It sounds like
BS. You might as well wait for a little bit and see.
Yeah.
Because you're going to be waiting this ride in the day if you come back. So, might as well wait now.
Yeah. Yeah, walking through the queue now. It is 8:40. So, we started walking through the queue a few minutes ago. So, we'll see how long it actually takes to get on the, like, to the first room. And we'll let you know.
Transports waiting to take you to General Organa's secret base on Pokhara. I'll regroup with you there. The Resistance desperately needs your help in our fight against Kylo Ren and the First Order. Remember, it is vital that you keep the location of the Pokhara base secret. Lieutenant Beck, one of our top commanders, will lead you.
Affirmative. Transport is ready. Nine-Num and I shall personally see them delivered.
Thank you, Lieutenant. Welcome to the cause. May the Force be with us.
Commander Poldam and then a squadron of X-Wings shall escort us to the rendezvous point on Pokhara.
Roger, this is Black Leader. I hear you're a fine-looking group of recruits. Well, no time to waste. Let's get you on your way to the General.
Personnel, this is your final call aboard.
I am getting a high reading on the fuel pressure line. That's better. Check the binary motivator. Yes, I just won't be sure.
All recruits must be on board now. Transport is away in 30 seconds.
Therefore, good. No one had better like my drive.
Yes.
People, people.
I could drive also.
Want to see how it is.
Strategy ready.
Affirmative. Engines are on. Red 2, Blue 5, report.
Red 2, check.
Blue 5, standing by.
Engage repulsors and hold on, recruits. All ships, launch! I am Lieutenant Beck. As you heard from Ray, I have been tasked with getting you to Pokhara.
Red 2, Blue 5, keep tight now. Let's get ready to make that jump to light speed on my mark.
Black Leader. We're picking up an unusual signal. Are you spotting anything?
Yeah, I see it. We'll check it out. BB-8, what do you got?
There appear to be a number of small craft heading our way. Raise the shields.
We got a company. First order. We're out. Right to you, Blue Fire. We got a clear path for transport to make the jump.
I'm going to try to draw them away.
Copy that. Get us clear so we can make the jump.
Be ready. You won't have much time.
Where are all those TIE fighters coming from?
They're between the out there.
On them. Star Destroyers.
Get
out! We can't. We're caught in the tractor beam. He's pulling us in.
I'll look at some friends and make this a fair fight. Don't worry. I'll come back for you. Stay strong.
Is there anything we can do right now?
That idiot way took a...
No, the tractor beam will be too strong. It's worth a shot. Full reverse. Any other ideas?
Cargo vessel TR-141, identify yourselves. Prepare to be boarded.
This is TR-141. We are a civilian vessel. By whose authority are we being detained?
By the authority of the First Order, Resistance scum. Now bring down your shields and prepare to be boarded.
They're on the location of our secret base. Tell them nothing. The future of the Resistance is at stake. I have a bad feeling about this.
Attention all on board. The ship is now under the command of the First Order. Everyone lets it out and proceed to the right. Now let's move. Everyone out.
We will soon snuff out your meager resistance. You chose the wrong side, and now you will pay. The resistance prisoners.
You have what I want. You know the location of the secret base, and I will take it from you.
We are needed on the bridge.
Keep the prisoners here. I will return to finish this personally.
Bum, bum, bum. Oh my god, what are we gonna do? It's either this side or that side.
Every time we've done it, it's been that side, but it sounds like it could be that side.
Attention all on board.
Rescued, yay!
Bien ajustado. Mantenga las manos, brazos, pies y piernas dentro del transporte y supervisen a sus niños.
To the turbo list. Then head down to the escape pod base. Those droids are programmed to return you to Batuu. Hurry and don't get caught. Lieutenant Beck will guide you.
Recruits, for your safety, stay seated with seatbelts securely fastened.
Whee!
Fasten arms, feet, and legs inside the transport and supervise your children. Tell them it's a prisoner transfer. Did it work? Good. Now get a move on. There's a clear path to the turbo lift at the end of the hallway. Turn right. Probe droid. You're lucky it didn't spot you. Take those turbo lifts and stay out of trouble.
Hey, you're not authorized. Wait.
Bye. Your cover is blown. Find an alternate route. Who picked these two droids anyway?
Attention, Drone Breach. Treatment of Lossy or Nancy. There they are. Fire!
This game box just for us.
This does not look good. Try to find another way down to the escape pods.
Whoa. The resistance will attempt to rescue the prisoners.
They have neither the resources nor the courage to engage us.
You underestimate their conviction. Raise the shields!
Shields? I see no evidence.
Found the alarm! All personnel to their stations!
The prisoners have escaped.
How brave, but ultimately hopeless. There's nowhere to run.
Between 15 and 20 minutes, so it was actually pretty quick.
Yeah, don't be discouraged by the amount of people that come to the area, because they have a number of different rooms that you can go to.
Yeah.
Obviously a number of different pods and areas, so
yeah,
they get through quite quickly.
Yeah, it doesn't take too long to get through to the first room, to be fair. But yeah, we're walking through Galaxy's Edge now. We're going to try and get some pictures, and then I think on to Toy Story Land, yeah. Oops, sorry.
Yeah, that's what I just said. Yeah, that's what I didn't hear,
because you're not listening to me.
Yeah, we'll get some photos.
And then off to
Toy Story Land.
Oh, there's a Mandalorian!
Mando!
Let's go see the Mando.
We need to get out. Thanks for the visit.
Bye, Mando.
He's such a cool character, isn't he? Love the Mando. Right, I just got the photo I wanted. So if you want to see that, follow us on Instagram, I'll put it here for you. But now we're going through Smuggler's Run queue. It's posted a 25 minute wait and it is 9:30 right now, so see how long it takes. I don't actually mind what we get this time, because we've done all three of them now, haven't we? We've done gunners, engineers, pilots, so.
Yeah, gunner or pilot.
Yeah.
Engineer's a bit boring.
Yeah, engineer's probably the most simple. You just press a couple of buttons. I feel like pilot's actually quite hard, so. Maybe gunner, we'll see. We'll let you know how long it takes and what we get.
Hondo Onaka, and this is Onaka Transport Solutions. Today, I am offering the opportunity of a lifetime. I need flight crews to transport this valuable merchandise across the galaxy. Pilots to navigate, engineers to operate the ship, and gunners to defend the shipments. And that is where you come in.
Press all your flashing lights. You have unlimited ammo. And my engineers are going to fix any
to you all. You might need it. Today's flight takes you to the planet Corellia. You will be intercepting a First Order train shipment of coaxium. Gunners, you clear the path. Pilots, line up behind the train. And engineers, you harpoon that precious cargo. Now get a move on and know that I have complete faith in you. Flight engineer, repair test.
Hit your flashing buttons. You'd better be faster when we get in trouble.
Right, pilot, push the flashing button to take off. Pilot on the left, move your stick to fly right and left. I was just about to say that. Pilot on the right, pull back on the stick to fly up and push forward to fly down.
Now let's go get that glass out.
Whoa!
Right pilot, make the jump to light speed.
Right, just come out of Smuggler's Run. It was good, wasn't it?
Yeah, it was good. We were gunners.
Yeah, it was fun being a gunner.
Killed 13.
I killed 5, apparently. So.
And we both got the rank of pirate.
Yar! Pirates we are! Oh, stormtroopers!
Oh! Has this young man ever obtained your reply to the human
love the stormtroopers, they're so fun. Right, so we're going to Toy Story Land, yes?
Yeah.
Make our way to Toy Story Land, see if we can do Toy Story Mania. I think Slinky Dog's down, or it was the last time we looked. But we're not bothered about Slinky Dog's fine, so Toy Story Mania, hopefully the queue's not too big. We will see. We'll let you know when we get to Toy Story Land. Alright, going through Toy Story Land now. Slinky is down. So Alien Swirling Saucers has 40 minutes and Toy Story Mania has 50 or 55 minutes. But that's fine, we want to do it anyway, so we're just going to wait in the queue and see how long it takes. Smuggler's Run was not 25 minutes, it was like 10 max. So I don't know if they just inflated the times or if it changed quite drastically, but yeah, it was a lot less than 25. We basically walked through the queue and then got to the middle bit where they gave us gunners and stuff, and that was pretty much done. So yeah, it was like 5-10 minutes max, but yeah. So we'll see how accurate Toy Story Mania is. It's probably gonna be busy because Slinky's down, but we will see. And obviously there's quite a lot of people here, as you can see, so. It's getting in the queue now, and it is 9:50. So we'll see how long it takes. It says 40 minutes now, so it's gone down slightly, but we will see how long it takes. I should think so. But like I just said about Smuggler's Run, that was only like 10 minutes. I said it was 25.
It's a walk.
Yeah. 10 minutes just to walk through the queue. So. I mean, it does look a little bit busier, but. Yeah, we'll see.
They've got both tracks running, this year.
Yeah.
It's when they've closed one track down.
Yeah. But we'll let you know.
You'll be waiting for what a treat. So sweet to compete with Jesse, Bobby Beth, and Stinky Pete, be you. Andy's room is humming, cause company is coming.
So he got 160, I got 114. Accuracy's pretty similar though.
Yeah, I've had a higher score before. That was not great. I was trying to like hit things like, while we watched on TikTok.
Yeah.
I was trying to concentrate on hitting those things, but in the end it didn't
work out. So
and the rounds are so quick, so it's hard, isn't it? Carried
on as a little
more. Not terrible scores, but not the best.
About how much it takes out of your arms.
Yeah, I know. We're just here at ABC Commissary. I got the pork carnitas tacos. Looks pretty good. I think I've had this before. And you got?
I've got a kid's meal. It's a ham and cheese, toasty with some chips, chocolate milk, and cookies.
Nice. It's quite small, but.
Yeah,
it's like the smallest kids meal.
But it's the smallest kids meal I've seen the whole
time. Yeah, trip. I was going to say, most normally the kids meal is quite big.
I'm pretty sure last time I was here as well, work was this.
Mine looks quite good, so I'm going to eat this now and then see what we can do afterwards, because Mickey and Minnie's is a really long wait. So Toy Story was about half an hour, so it was posted at like 40 minutes, but it's actually about half an hour. So yeah, going to eat this. Right, it is later on in the day. We're walking down the stairs at our resort, going to Epcot. We have a single pass lightning lane for Guardians of the Galaxy Cosmic Rewind. Yes!
Yep.
So that's gonna be good. I want September. Pray for me that we get September. September! Also, I read online that on 21st of September they're just playing September the whole way through. If you're here on the 21st, you are lucky, because you will just get September. Oh, it's really hot still. What time is it? It's 5:30.
It's hotter now than it was.
Yeah, it's pretty warm. It's 5:30. Our lightning lane is plane going over. Hang on. Right, our lightning lane is at 6:50 to 7:50. And the only other ride we kind of want to do is Soarin', so we'll see what the wait time is for that, and then maybe walk around the showcase a bit, get some food. Stepped over, and that's about it. So yeah, Guardians is going to be the main thing for today. Hopefully the bus is not too busy, but we'll see what it's like when we get to Epcot. All right, we're here in Epcot now with Epcot Mall. What are we going to do first? Are we going to try and do Soarin' or not?
I don't know. I said 70 minutes when I last looked.
Yeah, it's quite long for Soarin', but...
Still says 70 minutes.
70.
80 now. It's going up. I think,
people
are leaving, and as they're leaving, they're coming in and going Soarin' before they go.
Maybe.
It's that time where like there's a lot of people like coming this way.
Yeah, and the entrance wasn't busy at all, so.
So
I don't know.
I think a lot of people are probably going on it before they leave.
But we've got an hour until our lightning lane for Guardians. So kind of want to do something.
Do special about it.
We did special about the other day though.
I know. It's
and it kept getting stuck on us.
It's literally a walk on.
Well, we can do it if you want. And it just got
something
stuck
to do.
And, where'd that come from? Just got water all over my legs. Yeah, that's weird. Literally my legs like wet. What the hell? Strange.
It's something to do, so.
Yeah. Well, we're gonna do Spaceship Earth. I showed you it the other day, so I'm not gonna vlog it again, but yeah, I'm gonna go on this again, sure, why not? Backwards. Why is it every single time? It was right close to the exit, to be fair, so it wasn't like it was before. But why does it always stop when we're going backwards? I hate that. Oh. Anyway, we're outside now.
To the land.
Okay, so we're going towards Living with the Land and Soarin'. Soarin's gone down to 40 minute wait now, which isn't too bad. Then when the land's always like 5-10 minutes, so might as well go do that while we're there. So we'll see when we get to the land. Alright, we're here at Soarin' now. Ooh, it says it's only 20 minutes. We will have to see if that is correct. It is 6:15 and we're just about to go in the queue, so
Let's see.
Hello, welcome to Soarin. My name is Patrick, and I'll be your chief flight attendant today. We'll begin boarding in a few minutes, but first I'd like to acquaint you with some important safety information.
Took us long enough to get them.
Ready to town. We are ready for takeoff.
Soarin. It was about 30 minutes on and off within 35 minutes, and now we're just doing living with the land while we're here. Guardians, because it's time for our lightning lane. It's 20 past six now, so I'm gonna go and do Guardians. I'm not gonna film it this time. I'll just let you know what song we've got once we get off. So you'll see us once we're off Guardians. Just coming out of Guardians now. Epcot ball looks pretty. What song did we get?
forgot. Disco Inferno.
Again.
Again. Third time.
Yeah. Third time we've had that song. But
third time out of four.
Yeah.
Overall, that we've done it over two trips.
Oh well. Never mind. No, because we had September one.
Yeah, third time out of four.
Yeah, we had Iran as well though.
Oh yeah, of course we did. Yeah, sorry. Third time out of five.
Yeah, insane. First time we ever rode it, we got September.
Yeah.
And then we've had Disco Inferno each time, apart from last time, which was Iran. Slightly irritating, but it's better than Conga, I suppose.
Yeah, we haven't had the Conga curse yet.
No. But it's fine, I just wanted to Denmark. Oh well.
We're probably saving it all for the 21st.
Yeah, wish we were here on the 21st. Never mind. Anyway, someone's hungry, so we've got to go get him food before he starts whinging.
Well, I got that kids' lunch thing, and that's all I'm at.
ABC, come in Surrey this morning. Yes, what are you going to get?
I think I'm going to get the fish and chips again, I think.
Oh, okay, from UK.
Yeah.
Okay, so we're going to make our way around the World Showcase to the UK Pavilion then and get him some food.
Luminous.
Yeah, so it's nearly 8 o'clock, so yeah, I'm going to go there now. From the China Pavilion, the scallion noodles, which has got shrimp on it. It looks quite nice. I've not had that before. And then again, the dumplings that I've already had before. And we're standing here. Looks pretty. But yeah, I'm gonna eat these now, see what they're like. Right, just walking through China now. I ate my thingy bobs. Dumplings, same as always. They just didn't put as much garnish on them as they normally do, so they weren't presented as well. But apart from that, they tasted the same, fine. Oh, right. And the noodles, decent, didn't have much flavour, and they were quite oily. Apart from that, fine. The shrimp was good. They were like, sort of like, I don't know, I don't think they were deep fried, but they had like a deep fried sort of coating on it, so it was quite nice. But yeah, the actual noodles were a little bit oily. I don't mind, because I like, you know, Chinese takeaway at home, and they're pretty oily, so I don't really mind that. But if you don't like oil and you want a bit more flavour, then maybe avoid that. I think they were better than the Thai ones that I had the other day. I didn't like them as much. They were sort of like chow mein-y sort of noodles, but yeah. That's fine, I would have it again probably. But then I like Chinese noodles, so. Right, we're walking through, where are we? Norway. Walking through Norway, it's pretty busy. And I'm gonna try and find somewhere to sit for the fireworks for the LUMIONOUS show. So we'll let you know where we go when we sit there, when we find somewhere to sit. Got our spot for LUMIONOUS. We are just behind the shop exit. Yeah, the shop that's nearest to Mexico, that's kind of in the middle, I don't know what it's called. But yeah, sitting here, there's a big flame there. And you can see the America Pavilion there. So hopefully this view is okay. I don't really want to stand up, but I feel like everyone's going to stand up, so. We'll be right back.
in the room now. What do you think of LUMIONOUS?
I thought it was quite good. Yeah, it's a good show. I thought it got better towards the end.
Yeah, I
don't like when they do songs from the films, but not the original.
You mean cover songs?
Version.
Like when they cover them.
Yeah, when they cover them with, yeah not the original songs there. Or the original person who sung it. It's
someone just, doing a pop version.
Yeah, I feel like it takes it away from what it is a little bit.
Okay.
When they did the original song that they did at the end, like that isn't part of a film. So I felt more connected to that than I did the other one. So that's why I thought the end was better than the beginning.
Oh, fair enough. Yeah, it was alright. It was quite good. I think like it was better than Harmonious, but it was kind of like on par, I think.
It wasn't
like a million times better, but
it's not Happy Ever After, it's not any of those kind of things for me. I know we've seen in other people's vlogs, it was mixed with you to start, and then they've liked it the more they've seen it.
Yeah.
But, yeah, I mean, obviously this is our first time seeing it, so, yeah.
But, yeah, it was good. It was fine. Yeah. But, yeah, we're back in the room now. You had to get food from the food court, because basically we were walking around the showcase trying to get my food from China. We'll walk past the UK. You wanted to get food from the UK, but then we didn't want to walk
back. I wasn't hugely bothered about getting it specifically from the UK, but I just, yeah, we got yours, and then by the time
we didn't want to walk back, basically.
We didn't want to walk back. My feet are sore, like, legs are aching. Like, I'm starting to feel like we're 11, 12 days in, whatever it is.
So, chicken tendies.
So I just got some simple, food. It was massive queues, weren't there, for food here as well?
Yeah, it was a huge queue. I guess people were coming back from the parks, but yeah. We're going to end the vlog here. So if you got this far, thanks for watching. Give the video a like, comment, subscribe, and all that good stuff. And we will see you on the next one.
Bye.